This is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com, and today I'm remembering Edgar Dean Mitchell. And he's famous for being the sixth man to walk on the moon, one of the Apollo astronauts from the United States. He also founded the Institute of Noetic Sciences, and he's important to me because he was one of my first and most influential mentors. He was someone that I've been communicating and conversing with by email for about 16 years, and I've got a picture of him. This is the two of us together. This is taken back in 6 years ago, 2010, back in February, at an Institute of Noetic Sciences event. He's extremely important to me, and I think to the world, for his interest in consciousness. And what I would like to do today is share some of the insights that I personally gained from him, not just through his books, which are very extraordinary, such as Psychic Exploration, A Challenge for Science. This is an early book that he wrote. More recently, he wrote The Way of the Explorer, which has now come out in a new edition just in the last few years. So those two books are quite excellent. And then, in addition to that, of course, he did start the Institute of Noetic Sciences. When he was out in space, coming back from the moon, he looked at the Earth and he had an epiphany, recognizing that he himself, in a way, was an extraterrestrial, and looking at how beautiful and peaceful the planet looked, noticing that from that distance, such as the moon, I mean, when you look in the sky, you're used to seeing the moon in the sky. If you look in the sky and you're in the Apollo spacecraft and you see the Earth, it's about the same amount of wonder and amazement that you get. For Edgar Mitchell, it was life-changing. In that amazing experience, he had an epiphany that resulted in him starting the Institute of Noetic Sciences and pursuing the rest of his life the pursuit of exploring consciousness. Some of the things that he emphasized over the many years that I've been communicating and chatting with him is that the map is not the territory. And he had a really great way of describing that, which is actually in his book, The Way of the Explorer. It says, this leads to the point that our beliefs are our map of reality. We do not perceive reality directly, but only the information our senses present to the brain at any given moment, which is then compared with the existing remembered experiences to obtain meaning. Because this map is the only reality we humans know, we often make the mistake of thinking that our map is reality itself, when in fact it is just an incomplete portrait painted from memory. And that is a point that he and I talked about quite a lot. He would often bring it back to my attention when we were conversing. We didn't always see exactly eye to eye, because when he was reading the manuscript for my book Reality Shifts, he was pointing out his preference for a Bohmian holographic view, a Bohmian interpretation of quantum physics. I was looking forward to getting some fresh insight from him actually this month, when he passed away. I was planning to invite him to, I'd invited him a number of months ago to be a guest on my radio show, Living the Quantum Dream, because he does have such amazing insights, and he's written papers on the idea of the quantum hologram and how that's a good way to look at how all of nature evolves and the role of consciousness in the world. So those are his viewpoints. I told you we didn't see totally eye to eye, because I also was interested in several other interpretations, including, as you know, John Kramer's transactional interpretation. I've recently interviewed him on Living the Quantum Dream. I'm fascinated by the multiverse and the many worlds hypothesis, and putting that in a little bit of a hybrid form with the holographic concept. And so these are my own personal preferences, but as far as believing something, I'm just like Edgar Mitchell, and we shared that same sense of excitement, finding out when will we know which of the interpretations is correct. And in the meantime, we know the math works for quantum physics, but that means we can build bombs, nuclear reactors, we can even build a quantum computer. However, the exciting thing for me personally about quantum computation is that now that we're looking at how to do the algorithms to move forward, we actually do need to understand quantum logic at a level much greater than we've ever really understood it before. So I believe quantum computing, as well as quantum cognition, quantum biology, and all the things I bring up on my radio show, Living the Quantum Dream. These are vitally important pieces of the puzzle. And I know that Edgar is still with us. I wanted to share a couple more things with you that were extraordinary about Edgar. Just after I met him, very soon after, he was sharing with me some remarkable personal experiences that he was undergoing, which was facing cancer. And in my book Reality Shifts, I talk about healing. He was familiar with it, having worked at IONS, been the director and the founder of that organization. So he was quite touched and moved when the board members at IONS organized a healing session for him. And he told me about it, and he experienced wonderful positive results, because that was way back in, you know, the early 2000s. It was about 15 years ago. So he lived a long time after that diagnosis, and it was remarkable. He's famous also for the UFO disclosure. He never really talked to me much about ETs or UFOs, except to say that he did feel that this subject should be opened up and the obfuscation stopped. So I've actually got a blog post sharing some of my exchange, some of the email highlights that I've had with Edgar Mitchell back at the beginning when we were first chatting about things. And I'd love you to check that out. Until next time, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com, asking you to keep exploring how good can it get. Thank you.